there's going to be a lot of Ron's lies that have happened. So what we're going to do is, rather than have him go and tell you all these lies, you can go to DeSantisLies.com. But every time he lies, Drake University, don't turn this into a drinking game, because you will be overserved by the end of the night. Well, I think the next president needs to have moral clarity. I think you need to have moral clarity to understand that it's taxpayer money, not your own money. I think you need to have moral clarity to understand that when you're dealing with dictators in the world, that we always have to fight for democracies and human rights and protecting Americans and preventing war. And so when you look at Donald Trump, I have said, I think he was the right president at the right time. I agree with a lot of his policies, but his way is not my way. I don't have vengeance. I don't have vendettas. I don't take things personally. For me, it's very much about no drama, no whining, and getting results and getting them done. This is not a time where you have to have pettiness. I wish Donald Trump was up here on the stage. He's the one that I'm running against. He's the one that I wish would be here. He needs to be defending his record. Well, first of all, bless his heart, DeSantisLies.com. We have never raised a tax. I think it's time we have an accountant in the White House. We have to have someone that respects taxpayer dollars. If 8% of our budget is interest, quit borrowing. Cut up the credit cards. I had to balance a budget as governor. You have to balance a budget every day. Why is Congress the only group that refuses to balance a budget? If leadership's about getting things done, how did you blow through $150 million in your campaign and you were down in the polls?
So here,
you
here's
are not... I think I hit a nerve. What I will tell you is, look, if you can't manage a campaign, it's been a revolving door of political people in and out of his campaign. You've heard of campaign people going to blows with each other because they can't all agree. $150 million, and he spent more on private planes than commercials. I flew commercial. I stayed in Residence Inns. We went and saved our money. We made sure we spent it right, because you have to understand it's not your money, it's other people's money, and you have to know how to handle it. If he can't handle the financial parts of a campaign, how is he going to handle the economy when it comes to the White House? And he goes and he has been demeaning me over and over again, telling lies to DeSantisLies.com because he thinks it makes him look bigger. But in the one basic thing, you've campaigned for president in one state, you're invisible in New Hampshire, you're invisible in South Carolina, you're in fifth place, you've got $150 million and you've gone down in the polls in Iowa. Why should we think you can manage or do anything in this country?
Thank you. Governor
DeSantis. What we need to do is not just ban a wall. We need to put 25,000 Border Patrol and ICE agents on the ground and let them do their job. We need to defund sanctuary cities once and for all. No more safe havens for illegal immigrants. These fellas don't know how to talk about abortion. I have said over and over again, the Democrats put fear in women on abortion, and Republicans have used judgment. This is too personal of an issue to put fear or judgment. Our goal should be, how do we save as many babies as possible and support as many moms as possible? That's what we're going to focus on doing. We're not going to demonize this issue anymore. We're not going to play politics with this issue anymore. We're going to treat it like the respectful issue that it is. And the tropes that you want to talk about, you keep saying, where is anybody talking about putting a woman in jail or giving her the death penalty? South Carolina. There is legislation right now that would put a woman in jail if she got an abortion.
Thank you, Governor.
That's why I say
that.
Thank
you, Governor.
Donald Trump basically said that the election was stolen. He went on and on talking about the election being stolen. He said that January 6th was a beautiful day. I think January 6th was a terrible day, and we should never want to see that happen. Not only did I pass the first body camera bill in the country and keep our state together, not only did I move to bring the Confederate flag down, we came together as a state
you,
in
Governor.
Prayer, and we had no division, no riots, no
Thank
anything.
You.
We didn't need the National
Thank
Guard
you, Governor.
Because a leader knows how to bring out the best
so,
in their people.
Thank you, Governor. So-